Good morning. Welcome to Proactive. Joining us is Matt Halliday, President and COO of Canada Silver Cobalt Works. Matt, good to see you. How are you keeping over there?
Oh, we're doing great. Got a little bit of a rainy day today here in Northern Ontario, which is excellent because we've had lots of fires. So,
well, absolutely. We can be thankful for small mercies. You're very busy over there with Canada Silver. So thank you for your time. I know you've just initiated a multi-parameter airborne survey over large sections of the Castle Mine property in Northern Ontario. Can you tell us maybe a bit about how you set up the survey and the important data you expected to learn from it?
Yeah, absolutely. So basically, we covered all of the portion of Canada Silver Cobalt Works claims in the Miller Lake Basin and a little bit to the north west of those of that area of the Miller Lake Basin. And it's basically gridded on 100 meter lines. And we're really looking forward to collecting this multi-parameter data because it should be very useful for doing machine learning targeting in the future.
So do you have any expectations of what the data is going to show you, or is it still very up in the air? Because presumably the AI machine targeting, the learning of this is still in its nascency. It's not overly available, I would have thought.
No, but I think that, you know, ALS Goldspot has been doing this for a long time. Goldspot, you know, has been around since around probably 2015. And they have some of the most experience in this realm right now. So I think that it should work very, very well. And I think, you know, one of the main reasons why we designed this MPAS survey is to be able to collect information that is multi-parameter over all of our claim package in the vicinity we want to work. We already have a lot of excellent data. We've done ground geophysics, we've done geochem, we've done, you know, rock prospecting, we've done a lot of drilling, we have multi-element geochem, we have, you know, geochem data sets, soil surveys on the ground. So we have a lot of data to complement this. And I think that really works very well because we have also a resource, we have known veins, we have a historic mine with a known layout. And so having a lot of knowns can really impact the availability of the machine learning to find new targets in areas where there's less known.
Yeah, so you're going from a good basis already with, you say, everything you've done geologically and geographically on the ground, and then taking this survey to guide you for the machine targeted learning is just tying it all into a nice package. Now, you did mention the assay results. I noticed on the report from Miller Lake, they look very promising, but I know there was a bit surprising given the location of the samples that were taken in comparative to the previous samples. Is that correct?
Well, the most recent press release, we went a little bit south of the Miller Lake, of where we were trenching. Stripping. Sometimes I get the two mixed up in my head. So we were doing some stripping, but we did have to put that on hiatus due to the fires in Northern Ontario and just having heavy machinery out there and everything like that. So we moved to the south, we did some prospecting, and we found an Archean. I don't know exactly what it is. It's highly altered and possibly a metagabbro. And so, you know, in terms of it being an Archean rock in the Abitibi Greenstone Belt, I don't think it's very surprising that we have found gold mineralization. We found other gold mineralization on the property. I just think in the historical context of the cobalt mining camp, it's known for silver and cobalt. So this is really good news that the property has a lot of potential for gold mineralization. And, you know, we can continue to explore for that and be able to delineate new structures.
Yeah, it does sound good news, and investors will no doubt be buoyed by the thought of that. And when can we expect then, given this the survey you're going to carry out, what's the time frame you're looking at to try and gather and collate all that data and then progress using that as you go forward?
Well, I think that we're looking kind of at the time frame in the autumn. So, you know, we have the data coming in, it needs to be processed. We do have our stripping program for the summer. So, you know, as the summer winds down and autumn comes up, hopefully we'll have some of that targeting available in September, October.
Well, it sounds like you've got plenty then to keep you busy over the summer and into the autumn. And I know investors are going to be looking very eagle-eyed at the results coming out. But in the meantime, Matt Halliday, President and COO at Canada Silver Cobalt Works, thank you for your time today at Proactive.